Microsoft Word 2010, Part 1. Hello students, today we will learn about word processor. A word processor is an application software which is capable of creating, editing, saving and printing documents. A word processor should never be confused with a text editor such as Notepad, which only allows us to create and edit plain text. Whereas, while using a word processor, you can make changes and illustrate the text. Knowledge is power. All of us gain knowledge by reading and imbibing new information every day. The 21st century has witnessed a tremendous change in our lifestyles due to the usage of internet in our daily activities. We have slowly shifted our knowledge base to e-newspapers, internet articles, online forums, survey reports and even chats. This shift has raised a big question. How is such a huge database on various topics created and updated minute by minute across the world? The answer is writing. Many people across the globe have a passion for writing. They want to share their information with the world instantly using internet. In this manner, information is transformed into knowledge. The best friend of any writer is a pen and a word processor. Every single piece of information in our daily life is touched by a word processor directly or indirectly. Thus, it is very important for everyone to know about word processors. Students, now let us talk about important features of a word processor. The advent of word processor has overcome all the limitations of a typewriter, thus leading to the ultimate extension of the letter. Let us learn something about the various features of a word processor. Ease and speed. A word processor provides an easier and faster method to type the text. Editing features. Using a word processor, you can apply the editing features like copying, moving and deleting text. You can overwrite or insert a sentence, paragraph or word. Page numbers, headers and footers can also be inserted. Tabular data in documents can also be presented. Formatting features. It provides various formatting features such as boldface, italics, underlining, font name, font color, word art, etc. Storage features. It stores all your documents for future use, which can be retrieved whenever you want. Graphic features. You can add pictures, drawings and charts, etc. to your documents. This enhances the overall presentation of a document. Printing features. You can easily take printouts of your documents. Most word processors have the feature of WYSIWYG. What you see is what you get. That is, a document on your screen will look exactly similar to its printed version. Vocabulary and spell check feature. A word processor helps in keeping your document error-free as it has a spell check feature which not only corrects the misspelled words but also suggests the possible synonyms. It is also capable of rectifying grammatical errors. Mail merge feature. This feature allows you to send a piece of text to multiple addresses. For example, if you want to send your birthday invitation to 100 friends, the mail merge feature will keep the same invitation text for all and will change only the names and addresses of invited guests. Hence, this feature saves a lot of time and effort. OLE feature. The object linking and embedding feature allows a word processor to interact with other programs by embedding objects in a document. For example, if you have linked an equation written in the spreadsheet software to some charts in a word processor, and if you change the equation values, the charts will change automatically because an object of the equation is present with the word processor also. Okay, let me tell you about popular word processors. Number 1. MS Word, desktop utility. Number 2. OpenOffice, desktop utility. Number 3. Google Docs, internet-based utility. Number 4. Notepad and WordPad, desktop utilities. Number 5. LibreOffice Writer, desktop utility. Now let's talk about Microsoft Word 2010. Microsoft Word is a part of the Microsoft Office suite. Microsoft Word is the most commonly used word processor in the market. Just like any other word processor, you can perform four major operations using Microsoft Word. Creating and saving a document, opening an existing document, editing and formatting a document, previewing and printing a document. Students, let us learn how to open MS Word 2010. To open MS Word, click on Start, then go to All Programs, then go to Microsoft Office, then go to Microsoft Word 2010. The Word application opens a blank document with a temporary name, Document 1. It looks like a sheet of paper and it occupies most of the space on the screen. The small blinking vertical line that you notice on the screen is known as the insertion point or cursor. It indicates the position where the typed character will appear. The open application of MS Word displays two windows on the screen. The larger window is called the application window and the smaller window, which is inside the application window, is called the document window. The application window helps the user communicate with the MS Word program. The document window is used for typing, editing and formatting the text. Let's first start with components of MS Word Window 2010. MS Word 2010 has a very friendly user interface. It provides a rich set of functionality. This session describes in detail the various elements of the user interface. Quick access toolbar, title bar, ribbon, vertical scroll bar, horizontal scroll bar, ruler bars, status bar, slider bar, work area, application window, file tab. The office button of 2007 is replaced by the file tab in the Word 2010. The basic features of Word 2010 are quite similar as that of Word 2007. On clicking the file tab, we can create a new file, open an existing file, save a file, print a file and perform other tasks which are discussed ahead. Number 2. Quick Access Toolbar. The Quick Access Toolbar is located at the upper left corner next to the Word icon. It provides an easy access to most frequently used command buttons. By default, three buttons are present on it, which are Save, Undo and Redo. You can customize this toolbar by adding and removing commands using the drop-down arrow of Customize Quick Access Toolbar. Students, note that Quick Access Toolbar is customized separately for each application of MS Office 2010. Number 3. Title Bar. Title Bar is still located at the top of the Word window. It displays the current document, Document 1, and the name of the application, Microsoft Word, in the center. Number 4. Ribbon. The MS Word 2010 has a ribbon which contains 8 tabs. These are File, Home, Insert, Page Layout, References, Mailing, Review and View. These tabs have individual groups and the groups have different icons, pictures, which in turn represent different commands. The names of the tabs reflect their utility and purpose as they are easy to understand and are self-explanatory. Students, let's know more. To minimize and maximize the ribbon, follow any one of the given steps. Number 1. Click on the Minimize the Ribbon button in the upper right corner of the ribbon. Number 2. Press Ctrl plus F1 key combination to display and minimize the ribbon. Number 3. Right-click anywhere on the ribbon and select Minimize the Ribbon option from the displayed menu. This will toggle the ribbon on and off. Number 5. MS Word 2010 Tab Groups. Number 1. Home. Editing, Styles, Paragraph, Font, Clipboard. Number 2. Insert. Illustrations, Tables, Pages, Links, Text, Header and Footer. Symbols, Flash. Number 3. Page Layout. Page Background, Paragraph, Page Setup, Themes, Arrange. Number 4. References. Table of Contents. Footnotes, Citations and Bibliography, Captions, Index, Table of Authorities. Number 5. Mailings. Create, start mail merge, write and insert fields, preview results, finish. Number 6. Review. Proofing, language, comments, tracking, changes, compare, protect. Number 7. View. Document views, show, zoom, window, macros. Number 6. Groups in Home tab. Clipboard. The clipboard is actually a utility provided by software for the short-term storage and transfer of data between applications and documents using cut, copy and paste options. Paste can be used to copy hyperlinks. Paste Special provides variety of file format options to paste text and objects in a document. You can cut or copy the selected document text to the clipboard. Formatting from one place can be applied to another using the Format Painter option. Font, used for changing font sizes, faces, colors, text highlight colors, and for shrinking and growing fonts. And for converting formatted text to plain text via clear formatting command. It also provides superscript, subscript and strike through options in text and the facility for changing letter case, toggle, upper, lower, title and sentence case. Paragraph. This provides commands for bulleted, numbered and multi-level list. Increase or decrease paragraph indent, numerical or alphabetical sorting. To show paragraph markups, add, remove and customize the shading borders. It provides options to set fill color, align text margins, right, left and center. It also contains commands to modify line spacing and color background behind the text. Styles. It is used to change font, color and style in the document. Caption and emphasis options to format titles. Editing. Using this group you can find and replace text in the document. Objects and text can also be selected in a document using this group. 7. Work area. This is the blank area in the document window where you can type, edit and format the text. 8. Ruler bars. They are present on both top and left side of the document. The vertical ruler bar allows you to format the vertical alignment of text. Using the horizontal ruler bar, you can modify the indents, margins, tab stops and page measurements. The numbers present on the vertical ruler bar indicate the position of text on that page. The numbers present on the horizontal ruler bar indicate the location of the text from the left and right side of the page. 9. Scroll bars. The scroll bars help you to navigate through different portions of a document. The horizontal scroll bar is located at the bottom of the page and just above the status bar. By clicking and holding the pointer of the horizontal scroll bar, you can navigate through a document from left to right. The vertical scroll bar is located on the right side of the screen. By clicking and holding the pointer of the vertical scroll bar, you can navigate through a document from up to down. 10. Status bar. It is located at the bottom of the document window. It displays the status of the document which you are working on. It displays the number of pages and number of words. If you need more information, then double-click on the words option on the status bar. The word count dialog box opens, which gives the complete information, such as pages, words, character, paragraphs, and lines. Adjoining to it is a proofing error icon. Clicking on it will highlight the errors. At the right end of the status bar, you will find the view buttons and zoom slide bar. It is quite easy to change the view of your document. Let us try. Number 1. Print layout. It is selected by default. This view shows the document as it will appear when it is printed. Number 2. Full screen reading. It shows the complete page on the screen and also displays the multiple pages. This view has several buttons at the top of the page such as Save, Print Preview and Print, Tools, Mini Translator, Text Highlight Color and Insert Comment. At the center of the bar, it displays the page number and total number of pages, and at the right end of the bar, View Options menu and Close button are displayed. Number 3. Web Layout. This view enables you to see your document as it would appear in a browser such as Internet Explorer. Number 4. Outline. It displays your document in an outline view. You can move the text up and down, expand and collapse the levels, or change the heading levels. Number 5. Draft. It displays the document as a continuous text scroll where page breaks are denoted by dashed lines. This view is helpful if you are using an older or slower computer that cannot display the print layout view. Various elements like headers or footers, backgrounds, pictures, etc. are not displayed in this view. 11. Zoom slider. On the status bar next to the view buttons, you will find the zoom slider, which lets you zoom in or zoom out your document by moving the slider to the percentage zoom setting. Let us take a quick view. Clicking on the plus symbol on the zoom slider will zoom in the view, and clicking on the minus symbol will zoom out the view of the page. Okay students, now we will learn how to create a document. Click on the File tab and select the New option. The Backstage view appears. Select the Blank Document option from the available template section and click on the Create button, or press Ctrl plus N key combination, or click the New button located on the Quick Access toolbar. The new document appears. Okay student, let me share an important tip. Right click on the desktop and select the new, then go to Microsoft Word document. Let us talk about Word Wrap feature versus the Enter key. While typing the text in Word, you must have observed that there is no need to press the Enter key at the end of each line. Unlike a traditional text editor, if the text does not fit in a line, the word automatically shifts it to the next line. This feature is called Word Wrap. It automatically fits the typed text within the specified left and right margins. The Enter key is used only in the following cases: to place text in a new line, to mark the end of a paragraph, to leave a blank line in between two paragraphs. Alright, now we will discuss about formatting marks. While checking a formatted document, how do you come to know the position of tabs, spaces and enter keys? Word offers the feature of displaying some special characters called the formatting marks in the text document when the following keys are pressed. List of formatting marks. Space mark. The dot character shows how many times the spacebar key has been used between each word. Paragraph mark. This character represents the position where you have used the Enter key. Line break. This character represents the position where you have used Shift plus Enter key combination to mark the end of a line. Tab mark. This character represents the position where you have pressed the Tab key to mark the tab stops. Choose the Home tab. Click the Show or Hide button in the paragraph group. You will observe the formatting marks on your document wherever you press the corresponding keys. Note: Show or Hide button is a toggle button. Formatting marks do not appear on the paper when a document is printed. That is why they are known as non-printing character. All right, let us learn how